Keilor Downs College. Part of our intermediate contraband section. You're going to play three works for us today. Twitting Machine, Red, and You're Welcome. So please welcome to stage our last group, Keilor Downs Secondary College, Camden Borthwick, and Trent McKenzie, their two conductors.
Thank you. Thank you. same lines, then we try and do the same thing. We try and match volumes so that we're hearing each of those parts equally. So let's start before 9, 2 bars, and this is probably the limit of my math skills, but 2 before 9 is probably 7, all right, okay? So now saxophones. Are you crescendoing at the same rate that everybody else is? What do you think?
Probably not.
That's, you know, actually that's, obviously he's a bright guy, and you know how this when your teachers ask a question, okay, you can probably guess that the answer is either yes or no based on the question, right? So he's right, I wouldn't have asked that question. Now here's the one that's a little bit trickier. So are you crescendoing more or less than the group? See, that one's tricky. See, he could guess pretty successfully on the first one. What do you think? 50-50, right?
No, again.
So say it again?
No.
You're not crescendoing as much, or are you crescendoing?
No, we are crescendoing as much.
Yes. More or less? Or the same? You already said it's not the same, all right?
Yes. So more?
I think you're crescendoing more. Now, let me tell you, I think everybody else could help them a little bit. I think we could get a special more crescendo. I know we don't have lots of clarinets, but let's see if we can get a little more of that, okay? But the problem is that saxophone has a wider dynamic range, right, than flute. So if you guys are playing something in an ensemble connected, even though it gives you a specific amount of crescendo, you're probably gonna have to do a little less than they do. So that we get the ensemble. So let's start bar 7, all right? And percussion, you can also help us with this crescendo, right? So here's bar 7, everybody. Flutes, don't you? No, you don't play this, do you? Ah, never mind. No problem. Yeah, louder, okay? Ready, breathe. Good. keep the air going through the semiquaver so that we hear all four of those notes, all right? Then you do play an accent, but you want to come away a little bit so that the accent's not all one volume. And then here's the next thing. The quaver on 3 and 4 end, normally you would stress 3 because that's a stronger beat than 4, but because it descends, we're not hearing that clearly in the texture. So I want you to make sure, that we hear those bottom notes, that you project the bottom notes, so that we're going to hear the whole line equal. Does that come on? Let's try that again. Here we are, 9, same thing, and 1 and 3. Did you play that whole line, clarinets, up to the rest in one breath or not?
I guess I could try it here.
You know, if you don't, you know, but let's give it a try and see what happens. Or how about this? Let's try this. How about if you breathe in the second bar before the quavers, okay? And you breathe in the third bar before the semiquaver. So you don't breathe in the same place. How would that be? Okay, let's try that now. Same people, this is 9. And 1, 2.
Thank you.
done. Can we get a photo? Suppose the bowlers for me, please. Can you read it in the sounds? There you go, enjoy that.